Thank God I knew that I had the gene when I was diagnosed with breast cancer because it helped me make decisions more quickly. It helped me make more aggressive decisions about my treatment. It gave me extra information that I really needed to know as I was dealing with my cancer diagnosis.
If you are able to take the single site test for a mutation already identified in your family and no mutation is detected, you did not inherit the increased risks of cancers associated with HBOC syndrome. You do, however, still have the general population risks for breast and ovarian cancer, and your healthcare provider can address your risk profile and cancer screening options. For example, since a mutation was already identified in Lori's family, the fact that her sister's result came back negative meant she was at the general population risk for breast and ovarian cancer.
Having the information that I'm negative is just a huge relief. It's allowed me to go on with my life and not really worry about the future consequences of an impending breast cancer. I don't feel that I'm not at risk for breast cancer, but I am happy to know that it's not literally lurking outside the door.
Many people have comprehensive testing because there is no previously identified mutation in the family. If no mutation is detected on your comprehensive test, the chance that you have HBOC is significantly reduced. However, a small chance remains that you have an increased risk for cancer due to other factors, for example, another hereditary cancer syndrome, or a mutation in BRCA1 or BRCA2 that current technology cannot detect. If you have a negative comprehensive BRAC analysis result, your cancer risks should be estimated and managed by your healthcare provider based on your test result as well as your personal and family history. In some cases, the test will uncover a genetic alteration or variant, and the significance of this variant is not yet known. In that case, your cancer risk will not be clarified by your test result, and your healthcare provider should base your medical management on your personal and family history of cancer. BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations can be passed down from either your mother or father from generation to generation. If you have a mutation in a BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene, your parents, your children, and your brothers and sisters have up to a 50% chance that they have the same mutation. And other relatives, such as uncles, aunts, and cousins, may also be at risk. So when considering whether or not to go through testing, keep in mind that while not everyone in your family may pursue testing, knowing about a possible hereditary mutation can provide important information to your entire family.
One of my sisters, who's very proactive, kind of launched a family campaign and called up people that she hasn't ever spoken to say, you need to know about this gene. Some of them wanted to get tested and some didn't. And some of those who got tested were positive and some were not. And the ones that did test positive for the mutation took action. So in some cases, we have relatives who call us up or send me emails who say, thank you for getting tested first and letting us know because we got tested and we did the surgeries and we reduced our risk and thank you.
Other benefits of BRAC analysis testing include the ability to get a personalized risk assessment. You can then use that information to pursue the most appropriate medical management to help reduce your cancer risk. In addition, for many people, knowing whether you have a mutation can reduce anxiety and stress. All medical tests have limitations. BRAC analysis testing detects most, but not all, causes of hereditary cancer. Also, a negative test result is most helpful when there is a known mutation in the family. Finally, you may find you have a genetic variant of unknown clinical significance and need to be managed based on your personal and family history. Now, you may be wondering if your insurance will pay for BRCA1 and BRCA2 testing. The fact is that the majority of health insurance plans do cover most or all of the cost of testing. You may also have heard about the possibility of genetic discrimination, but the facts are that federal and state laws prohibit this type of discrimination. And most importantly, more than 100,000 people have been tested since the 1990s, and so far there have been no documented cases of discrimination based on BRAC analysis test results.
At first I started off with this huge fear of the insurance and, oh my God, is it going to be a pre-existing condition, and then what? And you know, that just turned out that I was just putting my energy in the wrong place, and the insurance companies were all quite fine, and it hasn't, you know, followed me or haunted me in any way whatsoever. That's the reality of that.
For me, knowing that I have the gene mutation empowered me to make vital health decisions for myself. In addition, identifying the gene allowed my sister to take the test. Now, she tested positive and is taking action. But all four of her daughters have tested negative and do not have HBOC, which I think is the best knowledge of all. Which brings us back to Rachel's story. When we returned to Rachel a few days after we first talked with her, she shared what happened when she and her husband met with her nurse to get her test results.
She's like, dun, 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 I have good results. And I was like, okay. I'm like, that's it, you know. She's like, yay, you know, your test results came back negative. You don't have the gene. To know that I don't have this gene is sort of one more thing crossed off my list of things that I'd have to look into in life. And to know that I'm not passing that on to my children is really, you know, just a huge weight off my shoulders.
I'm very happy that it's not going to be part of my legacy to Rachel, this gene. I'm glad that I know that.
Testing is an important personal decision. I can tell you from my own experience that it can provide information that will greatly impact what you do for your health and the health of your family.
I think women need to empower themselves with this information. Find out. Maybe you're negative. Great. It's a big relief. Maybe you're positive and you move forward with the information. But sitting around wondering, do I do it? Do I not? It's stressful. We like to know how much we weigh, you know, what we eat, what our cholesterol level is. Why not know this incredibly important information about the rest of your life, and information that could affect everyone around you and your family? So this is important information, and it's powerful information that can change a life.
Lori and the other women in this video feel that testing has provided important and useful information for them and their families. Now you need to decide, is testing right for you? It is your decision to make based on what makes the most sense for your healthcare and for your family. Thank you for listening. Good luck with whatever decisions you make, and may you have the best of health.